We're going to work some more puzzles and riddles, sometimes called word problems, where we might have to find more than one thing. So we'll have to define more than one thing, but we could still use one variable. Jamie earned 15 more points on her test than Paul earned. Their points added up to 143. How many points did each student earn? All right, so we're trying to find out how many points Jamie earned on her test and Paul earned on his test, so we need to divide both those. So we're going to write down something for how many points Jamie earned and how many points Paul earned, and either of them could be the variable to start off with. So we can, let's say we're going to use n for the variable. Now, notice that Jamie earned more than Paul. So if we knew how many Paul earned, then we could add 15. So instead of using x, I'm going to use p to remind myself. P is going to stand for how much Paul earned. And therefore, since Jamie earned 15 more points, you would take p plus 15. Now, somebody may have done this differently and let Jamie be x, and then you'd have to subtract 15 to figure out what Paul earned. Okay? So this isn't the only way you could set it up. Now, we know that altogether their points added up to 143. So I'm going to kind of write this not perfectly algebraically, but let's say Jamie's points plus Paul's points. We know that's going to add up to 143, right? So this is the way you might think about it. And so we could put in how many did Jamie earn? Well, P plus 15 is what Jamie earned, plus how many Paul earned, that was P, and that's going to equal our 143. Okay, so this is one way of writing the equation. All right, so now we have to solve this. We're going to simplify the left-hand side, 2P plus 15 equals 143. Subtract 15 from both sides to isolate p. So I have 2p equals 128. And then we're going to have to divide by 2. Running out of space, I hope you could all do that in your head. If you divide both sides by 2, we get p equals 64. So what did p stand for? How many points Paul earned? And so we could actually go up here and say we know that is going to be 64. And if Jamie earned 15 more, that means she got 79 points. So let's see if that would make sense. With these two numbers, does it show that Jamie earned 15 more points? Yes, because 64 plus 15 is 79. And if you add them up, do you get to 143? So let's do that little check over here. 79 plus 64. And yes, that does add up to 143. So it looks like these are the correct answers. So remember, you want to write your answer more clearly. You could say, Jamie earned. Okay, now how many did Jamie earn? She earned the 79, right? 79 points. And Paul earned the 64 points. And so we used a single variable, and we're able to solve this problem or puzzle. Next problem. One number is 10 times another number, and their difference is 63. Find the numbers. Okay, so we're looking for two different numbers. So let's begin by just writing. We're going to define the first number, and we're going to define a second number. Okay, now what do we know? One of them is 10 times the other number. So that would be the bigger number, right? But instead of putting smaller and larger, I just put first and second. So if the first number is n, we always want to let one of the variables just be a single letter. And then what would the second number be if it's 10 times as big? Well, that would be 10n. All right, now, what else does it tell us about these numbers? It says their difference is 64. Remember, difference means subtract. That's how we're going to get our equation. We're going to subtract the two numbers and get 63. Now, to subtract two numbers and get 63, you're going to have to do the bigger number minus the smaller number. So let's go ahead and pick the 10n. It's the bigger number minus the smaller number should equal 63. So what does that give us? 10n minus n is 9n. And then we could divide by 9. So n is 7. All right, so let's see. That means up here, if n is 7, the first number must be 7. And the second number would be 10 times 7, which would be 70. So let's kind of check in our head to see if this makes sense. If the numbers are 7 and 70, is one of the numbers 10 times the other one? Yes. And what about their difference? When you subtract, you get 63. You could certainly check that. 70 minus 7. Yep. Does add up to 63. So that means our answer could be written as the numbers are 7 and 70. I want to make a quick observation here. If I would have done n minus 10n equals 63, I would have gotten negative 7 for n and negative 70 for the second number. And it's true that their difference is still 63. It's just easier, really, for most people to think of the positive number 70 and 7. So there might be another way that you might have written this and it wouldn't technically be incorrect. All right, for this one, the difference between two numbers is 8. If the larger is subtracted from 3 times the smaller, the difference is 100. Find the numbers. All right, the key here is you're looking for two numbers, and we're talking about a larger and a smaller one. So let's define them that way. Let's let one of them be the smaller number, and one's going to be larger. And the trick is, how are we going to define those? One of them will be n. I'm not sure which one yet. So let's see what's given. The difference between two numbers is 8. Basically, that means one number is 8 more. Think about it. So, like the difference between 10 and 18 is 8. One is 8 more. So, if the smaller one is n, then the larger one is n plus 8. And again, you could have done this the other way. You could have made the larger one n, then the smaller would be n minus 8. You'd have to take away 8. So, here's one way we could define the two numbers. All right, now, next part. If the larger is subtracted from 3 times the smaller, so I'm going to loosely put what this is saying in words. We're going to take 3 times the smaller number, right? And then I'm going to subtract the larger number. That would give me 100. That's basically what it's saying. So, kind of in quotes, that's not real algebraic here, right? But we could actually put down n for the smaller number and n plus 8 now for the larger number to get the equation. So we've got 3 times the smaller number. Now the smaller number is just n, so that would just be 3n. But when you subtract the larger number is n plus 8. So you can't just write n plus 8. That's not going to work. You have to put it in parentheses because you want to show that you're subtracting the entire number equals 100. So be very careful that you put anything that has more than one term, put it in parentheses. All right, so now we need to do the distributive property with that minus sign. So I have 3n minus n and minus 8 equals 100. And then we're ready to go. 2n minus 8 is 100. Add 8 to both sides. So 2n equals 108. And if we divide both sides by 2, we get n equals 54. So let's see. If n is 54, then the larger number is 54 plus 8, which is 62. All So let's see if that makes sense. It says the difference is 8. Yes, you can see that. 62 minus 54 is 8. And it says if the larger is subtracted from 3 times the smaller. Well, let's check that out. We'd first have to do 3 times the smaller number, which is 162, right? And then we're going to have to subtract the larger number, right? First of all, we get 162. We're going to subtract, and we get 100. Yes, it works out. So we're ready to write the answer. So the numbers are 54 and 62.